Hey guys, welcome to another Elementor widget tutorial. Today I'm talking about the button widget. You will learn how to use it, when to use it, how to change it, and how to edit it. So we're starting right now. So on this website, what we need is, of course, a call to action, a button. So we go over here and we drag and drop the button widget right there. The first thing you'll see that with the type, you can choose default, info, success, warning, message, or danger. If you click on these, in my particular theme, the hello theme from Elementor itself, it doesn't do anything. But you can still see how it looks when you press this preview button, like there. The info is blue, the success is green, the warning is orange, and the danger is of course red. Let's first change the text to something like explore our plans. You can also let the text be dynamically filled, but if you click on this, we need Elementor Pro. We'll be covering this in the Elementor Pro widget series. Close this one. And at the link, you can add your page where it's supposed to go. This one goes, of course, to plans. If you click on link options, here you can let the button open the link in a new window. You only should do this if the link goes to another website, which is not your own. You can add a nofollow, which is useful, again, if you have another website for SEO purposes. And you can add some attributes, and you can add some attributes. Here you can change the alignment of the button within the container. So do you want it to be centered on the right side, or do you want it to be justified to take up the full width of your container? Because my container has set some margins over here. Now let's put this back on the left side. I want it to be over here. With size, you can change the size of your button. You can go with extra small, with medium, large, or extra large. So for this particular button, I would say we go with large. Here you can change the icon. Standard, it's set to none, but you can upload your own SVG, or you can go to the library. Let's go to the library, and here you can actually select and search through all the icons Elementor has to offer. What icon are we going to use? It all depends on the call to action within the button. Our call to action right now is simply explore our plans. What do I expect when I hover over this button? I would say an arrow like this, or maybe an arrow like this one. Let's press on insert. Now you can see that the arrow is on the left side. I want it to be on the right side. So now you get the feeling that when you click on it, you go further in the process. And we all want to go further in our lives, right? Then you can choose the icon spacing, how much space there is between the icon and the text. I like it to be on 31. And when we go down, we can give our button an ID. An ID is just a name tag that we can use to build some custom CSS around this button. We don't be needing it right now. All right, let's go to the next step, which is styling. Over here, the first thing we see is the typography, and again we have the global fonts to choose from. If you don't know what these are, follow my first video about the heading, and then I'll explain everything about the global fonts and global colors. For now, let's change the typography manual. We click on the pencil over here, and you can go to the family and you can choose all the fonts there are. Let's go with outfit. I like this one. You can change the size. As you can see, while I'm changing the size, you will see that the size of the button is also changing. So when I make it very large and I go back to my content tab and I change the large to extra small, now we can see actually what's happening. It actually creates more spacing around the letters. That is what this size option really does. All right, but we also can change that one with advanced. So there are multiple ways to make your perfect button. Let's go back to style. Let's go back to typography. And we're going to make it a little bit smaller. Of course, the weight. Here you can change how bold your text is. Let's go with 300, which is excellent, I think. With the transform, you can change the button text to the uppercase, lowercase, capitalized, or normal. If you look at this page, you see that everything is uppercase. So you might think it should be useful to use uppercase. However, Your call to action is designed to get the attention of the visitor so they actually click your button. So I would not go with uppercase. In this case, I would go to just default. Like this. Now the button really stands out. All right, here you can change the style if you want it to be italic, oblique, or default. Let's keep it on default. And with the decoration, you can make it underline or overline or line through or none. Well, let's just keep it at default. Then we have the line height. You can change to create more space in your button. I actually never use the line height within buttons. Maybe you have a big button with multiple lines of text, then it could be very useful. The letter spacing is useful to make it just a little bit smaller. I like this. The word spacing. Well, we don't need it in this particular button. All right, that's it for the typography. Then we go to the text shadow. Over here, we can, of course, create a little bit of shadow effect within the text. If you select the color, you can change the transparency of your shadow. It's now on black. So when I go with this one, we have no transparency on the color. And you can see it when I start moving it around. You can see, oh yes, there is our shadow. When I change the blur to under like 2 or 3, you actually get a pretty nice effect on your button. It kind of looks nice, but it really distracts from the button itself. So we're not gonna use a shadow within this button right now. We're gonna change the text color to make it black, because all letters are white and the black just really pops out. Then you can choose the background type. You can actually create a classic, which is just the color we're using right now on the button. But we can also go with a gradient. With the gradient, you can create any kind of button you want by just changing all the colors and the location of your colors. This, you can actually make it radial. This is really ugly. So in some cases, you can create something really beautiful with it, but mostly for call to action, I just use a classic background button. And you might want to change this color to something like orange, which really pops out like this. But again, if you want to have orange, you can also change your content type to warning, like this. That's also a way to do it, but let's keep it on default. We go back to style, and we're going to change this color back to our green one. Before we go to the border, there is another button which says normal and hover. If you click on hover, you can actually change the background color, for example, to go to red when someone hovers over your button. I wouldn't say go with red. I would say go with something like yellow, like this. So that's the hover option, which is really powerful with using call to actions for buttons. It's really great. When you also use the hover option, you get the chance to choose a hover animation. These are really a lot of them. The most common use is, that's why it's on top, is the grow. When you hover over it, your button just grows a little, change color, it's excellent. But if you want to dive in, there are really a lot of them. There are a lot of hover animations you can choose. The funny thing is, you should actually measure the result when someone hovers over it with which animation actually people click further on your website. It's really worth to explore this. But we go with grow right here. Right, if you go even further, we have the borders. In the border type, you can, of course, create a border. If you unlink it, you can create only borders on the top, for example, or on the bottom, which really gives you another nice effect. Of course, you have all the different kinds of borders that we know. And you can change the color, of course, the border radius. If you want it to be a round button, this is the way to go. You can also do it without a border type. Then you can also change the border radius to make it round. I don't like the entire round buttons like this. I really don't like the style, but you can of course do it, or make it just a little bit like this, which is pretty cool to make it just a little bit rounded off the edges. And there we also have the box shadow option, where you can create your shadow of your button like this. And then we can actually play around with it to give it some effect, which is really fun to do, but I don't like it on this particular call to action. So we're going to back to default right there. And then we have the padding, and within the padding, you can actually create more space within your button. If you click on this button, you will see what happens when I make the right one and the left one just a little bit bigger. And I can see that we can actually tune our button the way we like it. So if I don't like the size of the button in the top, I'm just gonna make it really small. This looks really great. Now we have a big button which really draws your attention to it. And when you hover over it, it gets yellow. All right, let's go to the last step, which is advanced. You can change the margin of your button. I always say unlink it, and then we go with, for example, to move it down, you can add 50 pixels on your top margin, for example, or just on your left side, and you can play around with it. If you link them together, you get, of course, this square in which you can change them. So with this widget, the padding actually does not create more space within the widget. Well, it does, but as you can see, it doesn't create a bigger, greener button. Now, to make that happen, you have to go to Style and use the padding over here, which is a little bit different than the other widgets we have just talked about. But we're gonna remove the padding because we don't need it. With the width, normally you can change your widget to full width, but in this case, it doesn't work that way. Because if you want to make it full width, you have to go to Content, and then you have to make it Justify. This is the way to make it full width, and not using the Advanced Layout option, Width. So keep that in mind. The Align Self option, again, you can move your widget around within the container. However, if you want to stretch it, just use the Content tab. And if you want to have it centered, you can also use the Align within the content, like this. It does exactly the same. However, sometimes you will need this when you have multiple columns and you have created a more complicated design than this. All the rest of the advanced options are not different from my first widget about the heading. So if you want to see all the motion effect, all the transform options, the background things, responsive things, all these things, just go to the widget number one about the heading. I hope you learned something new within this explanation of the button widget. If you want to see more widgets, just click on the next video and I will explain other widgets to you. If you just want to say thank you or you have questions, drop them down in the comments and I always respond. Because I love you guys. Alright, see you in the next video. Have an awesome day.